Hi everybody, Melissa Wyman here with Happy Trees Painting, and we are doing a series of quarantine videos now while we can. So we've been going live on Facebook every other night. My goal is really just to get a stockpile of tutorial videos. I've been working on a YouTube channel. That's hard time-consuming stuff. So we're going to be putting that out. We've got quite a few videos we've racked up so far, and we're going to keep doing this. As long as we can. So, and then when we're done doing it, we'll be back to painting with people and teaching you how to paint in person. So this is one of our examples that I made when the eclipse came through. I'm in Kansas City. If you're here, you know that we were right in the path of totality, so that was exciting. So just kind of musing on days past that we thought were strange. We had no idea what we were about to get into. So. Let's go in, and I'm going to start by going in and doing the background. This one is very, very, very simple, so if you're attempting to do this at home, the paints I'm using are acrylic paints, and I'm just using the primary colors, red, yellow, blue, black, and white. And then I've got three brushes here. I've got my square brush here, flat brush, got a smaller flat brush. And then I have a liner brush. So we're gonna just be using those three. Now, I am working on putting together some packages. I've got some deliveries coming. So since I've started doing these videos, people have asked if I had kits or things that they could have at home. I will have something like that hopefully by next week. So that should include your canvas, your paints, your brushes, all the stuff that you would need at home. So stay tuned for that. And let's go ahead and go in, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in for the background here. I'm going to use that big brush, and I always take it out of the water, tap it around, and then give it a good squeeze with your washcloth. Now I'm going to go in and make some purple, but the purple shade I'm going to make is going to be a little bit more on the red side than the blue side. So I'm going to get a pretty healthy chunk of red, put that on my palette here, and then I'm just going to get like a little corner. So I just stuck the corner of my brush. I'm gonna mix those together. I think that looks pretty good. Maybe just a touch more blue. Now I've got my paint mixed up. Before I start putting it on the canvas, I'm gonna take my brush and just dip it in the water. And then go ahead and stir that water all up into your paint. So we wanna get our paint mixed up, and then we just wanna dilute it with a little bit of water. And I'm going to go in from the top, nice long brush strokes, and I am going to bring this color down to probably about here. So if I were to give you a measurement, if I put my hand up here, it's about a hand length down. You get a little bit more water and a little bit more paint.
Hello, peeps. Chip Davis.
Hey, Chip. I miss you. Your hair's getting long. I've been seeing your, what is it, your Lion King picture? All right. So.
Eggplant.
Going in, nice long horizontal brush strokes. What I'm going to do after I put this dark color on is I'm going to rinse my brush out. And when you rinse your brush, you always just want to really knock it around in the bottom of the cup. Tap, tap. A little squeeze. Now I'm going to go in and I'm going to mix up, you can just do this right next to your purple color. I'm going to take a little bit of white, and to that I'm going to add just a tiny touch of blue. I can't stress enough, this phthalo blue that I use is really, really, really strong. So when you're mixing, some of these recipes call for just the tiniest touch of paint. So I'm going to get some light blue going here, add a little water to it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in right underneath, and I'm just going to do a stripe of this blue. Maybe I'll come down just a little further. Okay, so I'm looking for an ombre effect to happen on the background here. So when I have this light blue in, I'm going to take my brush, and I'm just going to go right up into this purple paint, basically right where these two colors meet. And I'm dragging, I'm going up into the purple, and I'm going to drag it down and let it kind of mix in So that gives us this shade of lilac. So we're basically mixing the paint up. And I don't want to do so many brush strokes that I lose all of these nice streaks of color.
And Jessica Bloom says she misses you.
I miss you too. Oh my gosh. Happy Sunday. That's a border day. So we're coming in. We got to get a painting party going at border when we're back up and running again. So underneath this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in and I'm going to take just a little bit of white. I'm just going to go again right next to this. I'm pretty messy with my palette. So a little white, tiny touch of red. So now I'm making pink. We went from dark purple, which was the red and the blue, light blue. Now I'm going to go in with just a little bit of pink. And I'm going to do that same thing where I just kind of come in and use my brush to sort of soften that out. Now the reason, splattering, we're going to be going in and getting into some yellow colors here. You may remember that yellow and blue make green. So as I'm going down, the reason I kind of have this pink here underneath the blue is just a buffer zone so that when I go in with some light yellow, rinse my brush off again, tap, tap, squeeze. So I'm going to take a little bit of white, just scooping up some, moving it over to the side, and I'm going to take a little yellow. I'm doing a few tippy toes of that. You can be fairly liberal. And then I'm going to add some water. So I'm going to go in right here. So basically what I was trying to say is if I'm going to start to put yellow on here, I want it to have this pink to mix with versus the blue, unless I was looking to make a kind of turquoise sky, which could look cool too.
Joseph Alt School says, I need to get my together and schedule this painting.
Well, so the kits that I was just talking about, I haven't decided yet. I think some will come with a blank canvas. Others will be more specific and have outlines done already on the painting. So I guess price will be varied on that. So we'll do the lowest price ones, just a basic, no outline kit, but yeah, this is probably one of the easiest ones we've done yet. So, okay, so we've got that light yellow color. I'm going to go in and just pick up some yellow by itself. So when I'm loading my brush up, you can see I've got a big pile of paint. When you load your brush, you just want to get a little bit out to the side so you can get your brush loaded up on both sides. Take a little bit of water, mix it into the paint. Now I'm going in with just bright yellow by itself, and I'm going to let that kind of blend in with the light yellow. I should mention when you're doing your background, a lot of this is going to get covered up with either the clouds or the trees. So like right there, there's a bristle. I wouldn't be too judgmental about little things like that that are happening while you're painting, because something's going to come in and go right over the top of it. So all right, let's take this yellow. Let's go all the way down here. So every time I load my brush, I'm going to hit that water and then hit my pile of paint. All right. So I do want to get a few streaks of some brighter kind of sunset colors back here. And the way I'm going to do that is I've got that yellow paint kind of pulled aside. I'm going to just pick up a tiny touch of red. This is, again, one of those cases where go very, very lightly when you're putting the paint and mixing it into the lighter color, because it can really get away from you. So I'm going to go in and add some of this more fiery color down here. I like to leave some of those streaks. Again, a lot of this is getting covered up, but it's just kind of nice to have this in the background. I'm not gonna go too crazy with it. All right. So that's pretty good for my sky. So I wanna make sure that I give this time to dry because I can't come in and put the clouds on top of it, at least the way I do my clouds, while this paint is still wet. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rinse this brush off and we're gonna go in and put in some shadow down here. And I also wanna get this shadow of the eclipse here as well. Okay, so I'm also going to grab my wine. So cheers, everybody. Still a paint and sip. All right, so I'm going to come in with my big brush and I'm just going to get some black paint. So I'm pulling out just a little bit of that paint and getting both sides loaded up. But I'm not getting my paintbrush completely globbed with paint. I just have it kind of coated. Now, what I'm going to do is I want to come in up here and I'm going to put a circle. People are kind of scared to do circles. I understand. An easy way that I found to do it is if you just take your brush and push it down. And while you're pushing down, maintain that pressure and just twist. And you kind of let those bristles do the work for you. You may have like a tiny little spot that needs a little touch up, but that's all right. So get a circle in here. Keep in mind it's going to have this glowing aura around it, so you're probably going to have to do some touching up later. So as long as you get a pretty good circle up here, you're good to go for the next step, which is to get a little bit more black paint on your brush. And then I'm going to take a little bit of water. Mix that in. Everything from here down is going to get colored in black. As I'm sitting here and knowing that I'm getting ready to do the clouds next, I'm wishing that I had brought my blow dryer downstairs, but I think it'll be all right. So if you're painting and you're not quite getting this coverage, you probably just need to add more water into your paint. If you're painting and it's going on and it's looking like watercolor and it's gray, then you probably have too much water. So it's just going to be figuring out the right consistency. All right. And I'm not worried about each brush stroke being perfect because every bit of this is going to get covered up with a highlight later. So I'm going to leave. Nope, I'm going to rinse my brush off. All right, so we've gone from black paint now. If you're at home and you're following along and you're painting, you can always get fresh water at any point that you want to. But I'm stubborn and I refuse. So I just really scrub my brush around, tap, tap. If you have any dirty paint water or stubborn paint that won't come off, just kind of go in and scrub your brush on your towel, and that usually does the trick. But when we go in and we do our puffy clouds here, you want a pretty clean, dry brush. So I tried to get as much moisture as I could off of that. And then I'm going to come in, and when it comes to clouds, I'm going to do a little speech first. So we're not going to use very much paint at all. I'm going to focus on putting the tops of the clouds in, and then I'm going to go in and I'm going to use my finger. So make sure you don't have a bunch of wet paint on your finger when you do this. And I just do one cloud at a time and I kind of build them up and layer them. But it goes something like this. So I've got my clean, dry brush and I'm just kind of touching the white paint. And then I want to move it out to an area where I can really kind of load it up bushy. So we do this with some of our tree lines too. But my brush is just kind of covered with white, but not a lot. It's just got the bristles are kind of coated. Now I'm going to come in and I'm going to do a top of a cloud. And so I'm kind of using the corner of my brush. So instead of just going in and stabbing straight on, I'm sort of have my brush at an angle. And I'm just going in and I want to get a nice kind of puffy top to a cloud. So that's the top. And then I'm going to take my finger and I'm going in and I'm just pulling this paint. And it's almost like I'm doing a C shape over and over again. Sometimes I see people pulling straight down. It's really more like this. So I want to leave that top edge crisp and kind of untouched, but come in with my finger underneath and do that sort of sweeping motion. And I'm going to do that again. Get a little bit of paint. So I like to layer these clouds. So maybe we have one that's right here. Let's come down. Now, the further you get down into your yellow, the less it's going to seem like you can see the clouds very well, but you still want to get a little layer there. All right. Now I'm going to come in. I'm doing that same thing where I'm going to go in and sweep paint over. Again, you can't see it as well down here. Okay. I'm going to put a few more. Since we can't see it as well down here, I'm going to just focus on putting a few more up top. Let me get a little bit more white on my brush. So where the top is, now that layer is now behind this one. So you've got to leave a little bit of this sky color there in between for that to kind of pop out. So you've got highlight, shadow, highlight. Let's do a little one just right in between here. Okay. Now I am going to go ahead and just put a little something down in here, even though you can't see it as well. And kind of to finish these off, what I want to do is I'm just going to come in and do kind of these wispy little brush strokes. Maybe a little bit more white. So I just put a few little streaks down at the bottom, and that kind of finishes those clouds off and gives them something to sit on. So pretty good with those. And then let's rinse that white off of our brush. We're gonna come in and do some trees, which are kind of fun. These are all gonna be done in black. And I'm just rinsing that brush off. So I'm gonna load up my big flat brush with some black and some water. I'm not going to go in and count the amount of trees here. What I want to do is I'm just going to go in and I'm going to put a vertical line where each tree will be, and I want them to be different heights, and I want them to be far enough apart that they won't just all run together at the top at least. They will all run together down here at the bottom. Shorter guy here. Maybe taller here. And maybe there's like a big one right here. All right, so I just went in. You can see that I wasn't too careful or precise when I was making this line down the middle. And that's because really ultimately I want all of that to disappear. I'm going to go in, get a little bit more black paint on my brush, and we're going to just make some real simple happy trees. So for this style of tree, kind of more like a pine tree, it's going to be triangular shape. So it's small at the top and then it gets bigger at the bottom. So when I go up here on the top, I've got my brush tilted, kind of skinny ways. You know, you could turn your brush this way and it's fatter. But to start, turn it this way and you want to just get a few little. Now, as I went down, I started to turn my brush to where it was this way. So now I'm going to go in and just. I'm sort of doing a zigzag motion. You can really exaggerate that actually. You can go in and just kind of zigzag and then come back in and just kind of touch up some middle spots. And maybe have some of the limbs go out a little further. But you want to still be able to see some of that background come through. So I'm going to just go on down through the line and do that. Let me do a really exaggerated zigzag just so you can see. You can do that and still make it work. So if you get that basic triangle shape, just come in. And these little naked spots here. And just add some little limbs. But ultimately, I'm covering up that middle line completely. And once I kind of get down here to the bottom, they're going to be touching. So you just want to make sure that you've got some really good distinction up here at the top of the trees, but I just let that run right on down into the ground. I'm also kind of flipping my brush around in my hand too. If you're watching, I kind of use all the paint on one side and then flip it over. Couple more here. These guys are bigger. You do have to kind of pay attention to the order of your painting because if we hadn't done these clouds yet, it's hard to go back. So this guy's really big. I'm just letting him spread out here. My white's still wet on my clouds, but that's okay. So he's just gonna go right off the page, and pretty much this whole little section's gonna just get filled in with blotches. And then, if you want to go in, if you want to make any little limbs kind of stand out a little bit more, you can always go in there and touch it up. I'm just trying to give you kind of an idea, but I am trying to do it a little bit faster, so you can definitely take a little bit more time. But I think that's pretty good. And down here, we're going to do kind of what I always call my magic trick, where I've got that big brush still. Just to point out, everything we've done so far has been with this big brush. So the entire picture, for the most part, with the exception of the detailing around here, that's the only reason I have those smaller brushes. So you can really do a lot with just one brush, primary colors, and this example is just going to be some yellow paint on top of black. So I'm going to go in and just get a little bit of yellow on my brush. And load it up kind of bushy. And I've got all this area down here, and I need to start to go in and make some little grasses. And so I like to come in and kind of do, if you do a little layer here, what's going to happen is it'll be brighter at the top, and then your paint's going to start to run out. And you kind of have like this little grassy section in here. And then you can get more paint. And maybe you have a bright section. This is similar to the clouds where I kind of go in and do a little layering. And I just have a tiny bit of yellow paint and I'm going in over the top of this black. Maybe right here, I'll leave a little bit of shadow kind of in between. Yellow. All right. So I kind of just want to do these little bushy things all over the place. Let's get another layer. I'm going to rinse my brush off because it's picking up the wet black paint underneath. So if you ever start to feel like you're picking up that darker color, you just rinse your brush off, go in and get more yellow, and you can have another little bright spot. Do a little bit more up here. It's hard because I can't get back very far when I'm doing these videos, so I'm hoping that looks all right to you guys. All right, so now I'm going to go in with, I forgot, we do use this little tiny liner brush here at the very end. I'm going to get a little bit of yellow. And we'll just go in right along here. And I'm just gonna do some little grasses that grow along there. You could also, if you wanna bring some of these up in here. So you just have kind of a combination of different textures. So I'm just kind of pepper a few of these throughout. Okay. I mean, you could just keep adding and adding and adding and adding. Just gives it a little bit of extra texture. All right. But again, hardest part is just to know when to stop. Okay, so now I'm going to come in here and do, see how steady my hand is. I'm going to use my liner brush and I'm going to come in and just, I'm just rolling it around a little bit in the white. And I'm going to scooch this because I got to get close. So I'm doing a line around. Doesn't need to be super, super thin. Cool thing is if you're having a hard time, or let's say you go into the circle, you can always come back in with some black paint and clean that up. So once you get that circle all the way around, and while the paint is still wet, so don't pause here, I'm going to take my finger. I don't want to get in where the black and the white meet, but right along the outside edge. Smear that paint out just a little bit. So hopefully what that does is it just gives it a little bit more of an aura. And with this liner brush, I'm going to go in. What was it called? The eclipse had like the diamond ring. It was the moment right before the moon totally covered up the sun. So there's like this big bright spot. So just put a little spot right here. So picture this is like right before the moment of totality. Now we've got some little shiny things coming out from that. So I'm just going to go in and do. Now this brush is pretty skinny, but when I do a line like that, I'm going to go in and just take it and smear it out. So let's do a few more. Let's go kind of like this. You have to do that while your paint is really wet, but you'll get that nice, really make it look like it's shooting some rays out of there.
Brandon Urban says, "Well, isn't that a beauty?"
Thank you. Were you there for the eclipse? Did you see any of this with your own eyes? I remember. It was pretty crazy. All right, we're coming in, and I'm just going to do a few little short ones. I mean, I could add more, but okay, let's do one. Okay. There you go. That's how it's done. So we're going to keep doing more of these quarantine videos at my piano. But also check out our website, happytreespainting.com. We're going to be having events again one day, so you'll be able to come paint with us in person. And again, look for an announcement next week where I hope to have some kits put together where you can have your own paints and your own brushes and hopefully follow along with some of the videos that we've already done, or you can request things in the future. But thanks for hanging out, and yeah, thanks for hanging out.